Well, tonight is our 17th annual Share a Night lighting ceremony. So we've had tremendous support from the community, especially our friends at the University of Delaware. But we asked individuals to donate $15. And so for every $15, there's a new holiday light that's strung outside. And the lights go on, and the funds are used to offset the stay, the cost of families to stay here. So there's a lot of people that come together to make those contributions. So we hope to raise in excess of $100,000 this evening. It was great from our partners at U of D, as you were mentioning, wish list drive. So items such as paper towels, toilet paper, cleaning supplies. We have 50 bedrooms here, and we're full every night of the every night. And so you can imagine how many of those paper products and cleaning supplies we go through. So when we get donations, that means I don't have to go out and spend money to purchase those things. So it really helps us to keep our operating expenses lower. So we had oodles of donations come out from your fans at the University of Delaware over that December 3rd and 4th weekend. So it took us quite a while to get our volunteers to put them away and put them in our pantry, and it'll help us out throughout the year. So we really appreciate it. And we have about 350 people here. So they come out to watch the lights go on and then to enjoy themselves here at the Ronald McDonald House. So they're getting autographs from the U of D, both men's and women's basketball teams. And that's important for our families as well as our guests here. And I know there's lots of little boys and girls here that have a poster now that's going to be in their room here at the Ronald McDonald House. So it helps to bring, you know, some of the holiday spirit to families when they're here going through a tough time, because they all have a sick child that needs, that are either in the hospital or ongoing a lot of serious medical treatment. So this brings a lot of cheer and holiday spirit to all the families here at the house. So it means so much to them.
We get an opportunity to do quite a number of community service projects, but this one is near and dear to my heart. You know, not only because I'm on the board at the Ronald McDonald House, but I get an opportunity to see all the hard work that goes in behind the scenes, and also the message and the intent of the house to bring some joy and some stability to what can be a very tenuous situation when a parent has a child that's sick. Being able to provide some relief and some, you know, a little bit of respite for just a little bit of time is very important. And I think, you know, what the Ronald McDonald House does is just a fantastic concept. And, you know, we're just happy as our team to be able to be a part of it. And again, you know, we try to do a lot of community service projects, but this one here is, you know, it really touches your heartstrings. But the turnout was unbelievable, and I thought the response from the turnout to our players, the men's and women's players, I thought it was fantastic. I thought they had a really good time in terms of getting the autographs and interacting with our players. And, you know, I can't say it enough. I think we have good players on our team, but I think we have unbelievable people on our team, and their character really shows out in situations like this. People will say that we did something tonight for the house, but the house and the people do much more for us than we could ever do for them. Just to see a smile on their face and know that we had a little to do with putting that smile there does 10 times more for us than it could ever do for them.